Hello. Good morning to one and all. I'm Dr. Jacob. Right now I'm working with Buhera branch, NMC. Basically, I was a teaching faculty from Kerala. I was working as an associate professor in the Department of Internal Medicine 2 years back. 2 years back, I came here and joined. Today, we are going to discuss about a very common topic. I know that most of you may be getting a lot of information through the social media and all other electronic medias regarding this topic, because it is over and above discussed topic, that is diabetes. But there are certain basic information which everybody should know regarding why, how, and is it possible to control, or what is our role as a person who is likely to be develop diabetes, or patients who are already developed diabetes. So today my topic of presentation will be focusing on the general information aspects of diabetes. When the blood sugar level is very high, that means there is an expected level of normal at different point of time. Maybe in the fasting level, certain level of sugar is considered to be normal, but after, in the fed state, after taking breakfast or lunch, sugar will naturally shoot up, but within a time frame it should come back to the normal. If that is not happening normally in a person, that person is likely to be labeled as diabetic. It is not always essential to label all people who are having a high blood sugar as diabetic, because even a normal person can have high levels of blood sugar at certain point of time. But if it is persistent, that means in different occasion, if the person is having a very high blood sugar level, that time we have to check and ensure that whether that person has reached to the stage of diabetes, then only we can label. The classical example is, if you are going and attending a party, eating well, your blood will be pumped with a lot of sugar from different moieties which we have taken. So it will be the high blood sugar level will be maintained based on the integrity of your kidney, because if your kidney is active, most of the sugar which is coming excess will be getting filtered and excreted through the urine. But if the kidney function is not to the level, to the optimum level, there is a high chance for maintaining the blood sugar for a long time. That is not called as diabetes. Another problem is, some people, when they go for a urine checkup, the urine may show sugar. So they will be panicky because the information given by the laboratory staff will be, your urine is showing 3+ sugar. That is not diabetes, because there is an entity, clinical entity, called renal glycosuria, in which the kidney is filtering excess glucose from blood. That is why it is coming through the urine. So it is not diabetes. So at any point of time, the blood, high blood sugar or the high level of sugar in the blood, or presence of sugar in urine, is never be labeled as diabetes, because there are certain criteria which has to be followed before making a diagnosis of diabetes. So today we are discussing about, what is diabetes? We already discussed about what is diabetes, and why this diabetes is important. What is the importance of getting a knowledge regarding, a working knowledge regarding diabetes, and at the short term and long term consequences of diabetes. So why diabetes is more important? Basically, because of, it is another disease which going to be affect from head to foot. All organ system of your body is going to be affected as a consequence of diabetes. Moreover, the important aspect is, it is a silent killer. Like hypertension, people may not be knowing that they are suffering from diabetes. Most often situation, when they come for a routine checkup, For some general health screening and all, when they go for a checkup, the blood sugar will be seems to be high. So they will then they will go to hospital, then do further checkup and all. Then only they will be coming to know that they are suffering from diabetes. Maybe it's a asymptomatic diabetes for a long time, or this may be a recent onset diabetes. And the consequences, sometimes the patient may be first time getting admitted into a hospital for a complication of diabetes. That means complication will take more than 5 years to develop. Till that time, the patient was unaware about diabetes. The reason is, some people will have a fluctuating level of sugar. Sometimes it will go high, sometimes it will be coming to normal or less than normal. Many a time, some people, when they go for general checkup, they will usually comment that, oh, my sugar is always low, so I'm never going to be diabetic. But when we ask about the family history, my parents are diabetic, my elder brother is also diabetic, but my sugar is always, whenever I am checking, fasting, it will be 80 or 70, and after food, it will be 120, 130. I will not be going to a diabetic in the near future. But the information is, all type 2 diabetic patients will have a very high level of insulin for the first few years. Because of this high insulin level, their sugar will be going below the normal level. So this hyperinsulinemia will be later on developing as a diabetes. So people who are having a very low sugar or a very high sugar, be careful about that your blood sugar is getting altered because of the unequivocal or unbalanced secretion of insulin from pancreas. So the basic information regarding diabetes, empowering people is why even American Diabetic Association or all other nodal agencies who are working on diabetes, why they are giving more health education related to diabetes is the actual role of a person who is diagnosed to have diabetes or a patient who is diagnosed to have diabetes, their role is more important than any physician. Diabetes may be treated by a GP or a specialist or a super specialist. Their role is limited. But people may think that my doctor is a consultant. He is expert in diabetes, so he will manage diabetes. That is a wrong notion. Because 30% of the diabetic control is from the diet alone. 30% is from lifestyle modification. Only 30% a doctor can offer, that is by medications, whether in the form of tablets or insulin or any other modalities which is available in the market. 10% from Uparwala Aadmi. So 60% from USI and only 30% the doctor can offer wherever you go. So it's very, very crucial to know more about diabetes and what is your role, how you people can be empowered so that you can manage your own diabetes. So in literal terms, the body does not make or properly use insulin. Either no insulin production, a relative deficiency, or an absolute deficiency. Absolute deficiency means pancreas is unable to produce any insulin, or pancreas is producing insulin but it is improper. That means if a person need 60 units in 24 hours, if the pancreas is producing 20 or 25 units, that is insufficient secretion. But one category of type 2 diabetic people, they have normal insulin or little more than insulin, but they are also turned to be diabetic basically because of the insulin which is secreted from the pancreas is unable to work properly. That is inefficient working manner of insulin because of so many other reasons which we will discuss later. So no insulin to move glucose from blood into cells. So what is the basic mechanism about, what is the basic way of handling glucose in our body? Whenever we eat something, whether it's a carbohydrate based or any sugar based, sugar will be directly getting into the system. But other molecules like protein, fat, minerals, all those things, whenever needed, it will be getting converted. Like in liver, there are certain other pathways like gluconeogenesis. This is alternate pathways producing glucose. But mainly, the glucose supply is from our food. So when we eat food, the food will be digested and absorbed. All the carbohydrate moieties will be absorbed in the form of glucose. Protein will be absorbed in the form of amino acids later, which will be utilized for building up of proteins in the body. And fat will be absorbed as fatty acids and glycerol. And trace elements like iron, calcium, sodium, potassium, all those things. So once the glucose enters into the system, the glucose will be carried mainly to liver. So from liver, it is going into the right side of the heart. From the right heart, it is going into the lung. From the lung, it is coming into the left side of the heart. From the left side of the heart, it is pumped to all parts of the body. So each and every cell need glucose. Just like the relationship of petrol car and petrol, all cells need glucose for its utilization. But the blood which is carrying this glucose near to the cell cannot directly inject the glucose into the cell. There is a mechanism which is called a lock and key mechanism. So outside the exterior of every cell, there are receptors called insulin receptors. So this insulin, just like a lock and key, it is a lock. The key is insulin. Insulin will go and bind on this receptor and open the lock. Then the way will be opened, then the glucose can go inside. So the key role played by insulin as well as the insulin receptors are equally important. This is the reason by which there are certain people, their insulin level is normal, still they are diabetic because their insulin receptors are not working. So for entry of glucose into each cell, a proper quantity of insulin and a functionally active insulin receptor should be there in the cell. So if for immediate activities, a certain level of glucose will be utilized by the body. But every time we are consuming excess, so naturally this glucose will be converted into a storage form which is called glycogen. This glycogen will be usually be stored in the liver or in the muscle. So whenever we need excess glucose, this glucose will be mobilized from glycogen to glucose. This is what is happening in the glucose controlling system in our body. So whenever a diabetic person actually, they have plenty of sugar in the system, but the cells are unable to utilize the glucose, basically because of this defective mechanism. So the literally the cells are starving. That is the reason by which the diabetic people, when they develop diabetes, after some period of time, they will lose their body weight because the cells are starving. The cells are unable to utilize even a single drop of glucose, basically because of this defect. A big obese 100 or more than 100 kilogram weight person, after diagnosis of diabetes, in 5 years time, if their body weight is coming down, that means their glucose metabolism is getting uncontrolled because of this improper mechanism. And basically, this diabetes is classified into three categories. One is the type 1 diabetes, and second is the type 2. Type 2 is 95% of our diabetes. In our day-to-day life, whatever diabetes we are talking about is type 2. Only 5% is type 1. Type 1, I will tell you, type 1 is an absolute deficiency of insulin. That means pancreas is unable to produce even a single drop of insulin. That is commonly seen in children. But from birth, these people are developing this situation. And the commonest pathogenesis related to type 1 diabetes is an autoimmunity. Autoimmunity means our immune system will be sensing our own pancreatic beta cells as non-self. Because our immune system is just like army people. They are always roaming around the entire parts of the body and sensing each system. So once the immune cells detecting our own pancreatic cells as non-self, that means it is not our own cells, they start attacking the beta cells and the full beta cells will be going into a process of destruction. So autoimmune destruction of beta cells from birth, which causes an absolute deficiency, which is called type 1 diabetes mellitus. It is usually seen in early childhood or infancy, even from infant. That is the reason why which one of the most important tests when a baby is born, from the umbilical cord, the first blood drop will be checked for sugar. Second is checked for thyroid, because these are, if you want to survive that child, you have to check, because glucose hypoglycemia can kill the baby immediately, and it is 100% correctable. So that that is very important. So type 1 diabetes is very important. And there are other types of diabetes, like gestational diabetes. Gestational diabetes is when females are carrying, when they becoming pregnant, that time they develop high blood sugar. It's a transient phenomenon, because during gestation only they will be diabetic. After delivery, they will be coming back to normal. The reason is pregnancy is a physiological stress. So during a physiological stress, their insulin secreting or the glucose handling mechanism is unable to balance the glucose in the body. And the most important thing is, this is a golden opportunity in every female if they are getting gestational diabetes, or even if an oral glucose tolerance test which is done during pregnancy is showing an abnormal value. This is a vital information for that lady, that at certain point of time in their life, maybe around 45 years or 50 years, or when they reach menopause, they are going to be diabetic. So the information is given 15 or 20 years prior to them during this pregnancy. So it's very important. There are so many other type of, like a young diabetes, or there is a overlap between the type 1 and type 2 diabetes. Sometimes young children, like 14 years, 12 years of age, may be developing diabetes. So there will be confusion regarding whether it is an absolute deficiency or a relative deficiency. What is the difference between differentiation between type 1 and type 2? Suppose if a type 1 is labeled as type 2, what will happen? Absolute deficient, insulin deficient patient need insulin for survival. No medicine will work on this category of people, because insulin is the only drug which can be utilized for making them to survive. That is important. So people who develop diabetes, like children between the age of 10 or 15, there will be overlap between the type 1 and type 2. It's very difficult to make, there are a lot of investigation procedures to, sometimes they will have, at certain point of time, they will be showing absolute deficiency. After some time, their pancreas start secreting insulin. So it's very difficult to manage. So LADA, MODY, there are different types of diabetic syndromes are there. That is more not very much important for a common man. But this is the most important stage everybody has to know, because every person who is developing diabetes are going through this stage called pre-diabetes. Pre-diabetes is the stage at which, if a person is getting this information that I am a pre-diabetic, you can stop developing diabetes, or you can delay the development of diabetes minimum period of 5 to 10 years. 5 to 10 years of time. The reason is, lifestyle is the only intervention at this stage for controlling this diabetes, or delaying the development of overt diabetes. Because everybody know that when they go for a casual blood checkup or a random blood checkup, if their random blood sugar is more than 200 milligram per deciliter is labeled as probable diabetes. Or if their fasting blood sugar is more than 100, they are probable diabetes. Or one more test which is given by the World Health Organization is called the HbA1c. HbA1c is a glycated hemoglobin level, because when the blood sugar level is maintained for a long time, this glucose is getting attached to different components of blood, out of which the most important component which is getting glycosylated is the hemoglobin. So the hemoglobin of red blood cells is getting converted into a glycated hemoglobin, and we all know that the red blood cell will live in our system for 120 days, an average of 120 days. So when we check the glycated hemoglobin in blood of a person, it will be giving an information which is 120 days prior. So the last 120 days, how much was my average blood sugar will be calculated from this HbA1c. That is the reason by which it is given us. Previously, we used to do the fasting blood sugar, then ask the person to have food and come exactly after 2 hours, again do one more prick to take the blood to check the postprandial blood sugar to make a diagnosis of diabetes. Now, World Health Organization asks everybody to check a single prick technique. If the HbA1c is more than 6.5, start treating diabetes. But Indian Diabetic Association and majority of the European society all category, because previously any value below 5.4 is normal. Any value between 5.4 to 6.4, 6.4 is the latest, but previously 5.4 to 5.7 was stage 1 diabetes or the pre-diabetes. Then 5.7 to 6.4 is a diabetes, it's a diabetes without intervention. But now they cut down that sub-classification. So any value which is below 5.4 is non-diabetic, or any value above 5.4 or 5.7 to 6.4 is now called as pre-diabetes. That means when your HbA1c is more than 6, the information is at any point of time you can develop diabetes. So it's very important.